The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 7th chapter, text number 1, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on April 27th, 1974, in Hyderabad, India.
Translation. Now hear, O son of Pritha, Arjuna, how by practicing yoga in full consciousness of me, with mind attached to me, you can know me in full, free from doubt.
Sri Bhagavan Uvasa Maya Saptamanat Bartha Yugam Yunyan Madasvaya Asam Sam Samadran Mam Yatha Gyasasi Tachyo. In the human society, it is a prerogative to know God. In the animal society, there is no such question. The human society is meant for understanding what is God. That is the privilege of human beings. We come to this form of human being after many, many births. There are 8,400,000 species of life, beginning from water, then on the land. In the water there are 9 lakh species of life, different aquatics. So, in the beginning of creation, the whole planet was merged into water. That is also scientifically modern science. And from shastras also we understand, pralaya payadhi jale dhita banasi vedam kesavadhita meena sarira jaya jagadisha. So, in the beginning, there was water. So there must be living entities, because living entities are everywhere. In the water, in the air, on the land, within the water, everywhere. Therefore, the living entities are called sarvaga. Sarvaga means the living entity can go anywhere. As we are now trying to go to the moon planet. So we may go or not go, but there are living entities in all the planets, in different positions. There are innumerable planets and innumerable universes also. And beyond this material world, there is another nature, parastasmatu bhava anya bhaktya bhaktya sanatana. That nature is permanent. This material nature is not permanent. It is bhutta bhutta praliyate. Everything here in the material world, everything comes into existence, takes birth, janma, then stays for some time, grows the body, then produces some byproducts, then dwindles, and then fades. This is the material nature. Just like your body, my body, it has taken birth at a certain depth. It is growing, and it is producing some children, byproducts. Then as we are growing old, then one day the body will be finished. This is the material nature. Either you take it personally, individually, your body, or this gigantic body of the universe. In whichever way you may take it, the nature is bhutta bhutta praliyat. There the material nature is, you take your bath for appearance, and again disappear, and again appear. This is the instruction of spiritual life. The spirit soul is there, but it is not getting a permanent settlement. This is material. Tatha dehantara prat. As the body is changing, there are so many children, they will also become old like me, but the spirit soul is there. In the presence of mother, although the body is changing, the mother knows that my son is there. Although from babyhood, the son has grown to boyhood, the body, original body, child's body, baby's body is not existing, the mother knows that my boy is there. So, this is common sense understanding. People do not understand it. Very nice common sense, that the body is changing, but the soul is there. Exactly the same example. The mother knows that my boy, my child, although he has changed body, now he is grown up, say 50 years old, but my child is, he is my child. Where is the difficulty to understand? Anyone can understand, but people do not believe in the transmigration of the soul. This kind of education, what is the value? The real knowledge begins when we understand that we are not this body, material body. I am different from body. Dehi nasmin jatha dehi kovanam jovanam jara tatha dehantara prapti dhirastatva navayat. This is our position. Then, when you understand that I am not this body, I am spirit soul, aham brahmasmi, then real knowledge begins. The first education should be given to the students that he is not this body, he is spirit soul. And because he is spirit soul, he has got a different business than to maintain this body. Maintenance of the body, that is being done by the cats and dogs also. They also take care of the body very nicely. They fight, struggle for existence, so they fight to keep the body fit. The tiger also, he fights, he secures his eatable by fighting. Similarly, this struggle for existence to get things for eating, sleeping, mating and defending, that is current in the animal society also. So, Shastra says therefore, Nayam deha deho bhajam niloke kastana kaman arhatirir bhujamidi. Shastra says, I am deha, this body, human body. Na I am deha, niloke, deho bhajan niloke. Niloke means in the human society. The animals, na I am deho, deho bhajan niloke, kastan kaman ahrati virbhujam. Virbhujam means a stool-eater animal. Stool-eater animal, hog. You know, although it is not very easily found in the cities, in our Indian villages, there are so many stool-eater hogs loitering in the streets, in the village. The only business is where to find out stool. This is the business. Whole day, night, they are working. To find out stool. See, if human being is educated to find out his eatables, Of course, the hogs which are inside the stool, they like it very much, very palatable thing. Similarly, we also, for some palatable things, we also walk day and night. But Shastra says, na ayana deha deha bhajan niloke kastan kaman arati. Why this human society should be trained up to work so hard simply for eating, sleeping, making and defending? This is not good. Then what is it meant for human life? Tapo, tapasya. Tapo dibbam jina suddheta satya. See, the human life's business is to accept tapasya, voluntarily accepting some inconvenience of life. That is called tapasya. Tapa means some trouble. They try to become brahmachari. It is tapasya. Just like we are prescribing this formula, no illicit sex, no intoxication, no meat eating, no gang. People want to do it. People want illicit sex. The whole city is full of pictures, simply how to indulge in illicit sex. Then meat eating, big signboard, and intoxication, wine shop, they want it. That is the natural propensity. Loke bhavayami samadda seva nittasya jantu nahi tatra chodana. You do not require to encourage them in these things. They have got natural tendency. That is material world. To enjoy unrestricted sex life, to eat meat, fish, eggs, amisha, amisha madhya seva. Amisha means eat meat, fish, eggs, these are amisha. And vegetarian means niramisha. So amisha madhya seva, madhya means intoxication. Either wine or cigarette or biri or ganja, bhang, teas, coffees, they're all intoxicants. So amisha, madhya seva and babaya. Babaya means sex life. You do not require to educate them. In the school, college, the boys and girls are not given lesson. Of course, I think they are now given lesson also. But naturally, without any lesson, they know how to do it. Similarly, without an education, one can take to intoxication. So these things are natural. But when we try to stop these material instincts, that is called tapasya. Tapasya. So human life is not to be carried away by the so-called natural instinct. Natural instinct, material life, there are two kinds of natural instinct. So long we are in the bodily concept of life, there are different natural instincts, and when we come to the platform of spiritual understanding, that natural instinct is different. That is real natural instinct. So that natural instinct, spiritual natural instinct, can be attained by tapasya. Tapo dibbam, that is the instruction of Vishabdi. Now people may say, why we should undergo this tapasya, austerities? If we want to enjoy life, why we shall voluntarily give up this and undergo austerities? No, there is reason. Tapo dibbam jena suddheta satya jasmad brahma saukham anantam. It's very reasonable. You have to undergo tapasya, voluntarily restrained. That is called tapasya. So why? Na jato suddheta satya your existence will be purified. And what is wrong in my existence? That we cannot understand, that is called illusion. There are so many wrong things. Always we are in miserable condition. This summary miserable condition is as described in the Bhagavad Gita. Janma mittu jaram vyadhi dukkha dosanu darsanam. That is intelligence. That I am now put under, although I have solved all my problems, but Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, you have solved all your problems by your so-called scientific advancement, that is all right. But where is your solution of janma mittu jaram vyadhi? Repetition of birth, death, old age and disease. Where is your solution? This is very intelligent question. Krishna says, therefore, that you have solved all the problems of miserable condition of life, that is all right. But you should always keep in front these problems, prominent. Janma mittu jaram vyadhi dukkha dosanu. Janma, the tribulations of Janma to live within the womb of the mother. Everyone we have suffered, but we have forgotten. Similarly, we are awaiting another suffering at the time of death. That is also suffering. Janma mittu. Then when we take birth, we get old. That is also suffering, and we suffer from diseases. But as we are spirit soul, that is described in the Bhagavad Gita, na hannate hannamane sarire. The spirit soul does not die after the annihilation of this body. That is our position. We are accepting different types of bodies. But we are eternal, part and parcel of the Supreme. Not only eternal, full of knowledge and blissful. This is our position. But at this present moment, because we have got this body, it is not very pleasurable condition. It is miserable condition. There are adhyatrika, adhibhautika, adhidvaivik, miseries. And always we are under. That we cannot understand. We are thinking that things go on like this. Don't bother about these things. Go on, eat, drink, me, marry and enjoy. That means, we are living very foolishly. Although the problems are there, I do not wish to die. The death is there. I do not wish to be within the womb of my mother. But I am forced to take a body within the womb of my mother. Then when I get the body, I come out. I am subjected to so many tribulations on account of this body. Old age, disease and so many. So actually this is the problem of living entities. That knowledge can be acquired in the human form of life and it can be solved. Not that simply we get the knowledge, but it can be solved. So, therefore, real business of human life to understand oneself, that is called self-realization, brahma-bhuta, and find out the remedy and act accordingly, that is the mission of human. Not like to dance like cats and dogs with a nice dress. That is not human life. This is the subject matter of Bhagavad Gita, our whole Vedic instruction. Vedaista sadvai ahameva vedam. This is God consciousness, Krishna consciousness, or self-realization. Self-realization means either you see yourself, or see the Supreme Lord. Either. But without seeing the Supreme Lord, you cannot see yourself. Just like without seeing the sun in the darkness, just like it is now night, there is no sun. So I cannot see also. In darkness I cannot see also myself. But when there is sun in the morning, I can see the sun and I can see myself. This is the theory. So, if we want to understand ourselves, right, that I am spirit soul, aham brahmasmi. Then we must take to Krishna consciousness. Now how one can take to Krishna consciousness, that is being described by Krishna in the 7th chapter of Bhagavad Gita. The first verse is, maya saptamana pratha jovam junyan madhasra asam sam samagram man jatha gasya sitasana. Because we have to see God. Just like I told you, if you see the sun, then automatically you see everything. You see yourself, you see your neighbor, you see the city, you see the house, you see everything you can see when there is sunlight. Similarly, if you can see God, then you can see everything. Jasmin vijñāte sarvamedam vijñātam bhavanti. If you can understand what is God, then you understand everything. Now why don't you take this process to understand God? And that is the prerogative of human life, to understand God. Why you deny the existence of God? How you can deny? You cannot deny. There is a controller, supreme controller that you have to accept. We are not free. We are being controlled. However, we are trying to become independent of any controller. And that is not possible. Prakriti, you are under the control of the prakriti. Prakriti kriyamanani gunaikarmani sarvas. Ahankara vimuratma katta aham iti mannati. Rascals and fools are thinking that we are independent. They are completely under the grip of the material nature. Everyone of you know. We want to do something. We don't want excessive heat. Why there is excessive heat? So that we have to manufacture this fan and air condition, so many things. This is simply a struggle against the control of the material nature. This is a fact. And we have to accept this. You cannot deny it. That is described. Prakriti kriyamanani gunai karmani sarvasa. Ahankara vimuratma pattaham itiman. Those who are fools and are scared, they are thinking we are independent. You are not independent. Under the prakriti, under the nature. And what is the prakriti? Prakriti is the agent or agency of Krishna. That is also explained in the Bhagavad Gita. Maya dhaksena prakriti svyatesa characharam. Under my control. Prakriti is controlling you or me. And prakriti is being controlled by Krishna. Therefore Krishna is the supreme controller. That is accepted. In the Vedic literature, Ishara Parama Krishna, Satchidananda Vigraha. Krishna is controller, we are surprised. How? I am also a human being and Krishna is also a historical person, human being. How he is controller of the whole material nature? That is answer. Satchidananda Vigraha. Although he comes as a person, but he is not a person like us. He is Satchidananda Vigraha. That you can understand, study. What is that Satchidananda Vigraha? Sat means Chitana. Chit means full of knowledge. And bliss, ananda means blissfulness. But so far my body is concerned, your body is concerned, they are not Satchidananda Vigraha. My body, your body will not exist. Therefore it is asakta. It is not soft. My body, your body is full of ignorance. Therefore it is not chit. It is achit. And my body, your body is not at all pleasing. There are so many troubles. Therefore it is not ananda. Therefore, Krishna's body is different from us. Therefore he is controlled. We think if Krishna has got a body, then he must have a body like us. Abhajananti mangamuha manasim tanumasuka. These Vuhas rascals, because I appear before them to give them the lesson about God, what is God, these rascals think of me as one of them. This is rascalism. Abhijananti mana mulha mana simta param bhava vajana. That Satchidananda Vigraha can control the whole material nature, that they do not know. Param bhava vajana. So, therefore, it is our duty to understand Krishna. What is the difficulty? Krishna is personal. God is personally explaining himself, what he is. And if we accept that, then where is the difficulty to understand God? Why you are making so much research work to find out God? God is canvassing at your door. Here I am. You try to understand me. Here I am explaining myself. No. We shall find out God somewhere else. This is called mulha. Navāga duṣkitana mulha parvadrante naradhamā. Naradhamā means not even ordinary knowledge of a human being. Lowest of the mankind. We are searching out what is God, and God is canvassing here. We do not accept. Therefore, naradhamā. Why? Māyā purita jñāna. Because their knowledge has been taken away by the illusory energy. But one whose knowledge has not been taken away, just like Arjuna was personally instructed by Krishna, and how he accepts Krishna. He accepts Krishna. Parabrahma paramadhama pavitram paramam bhava purusam sāsatam ādyam. Krishna, you are Parabrahma. Parabrahma. There are two words, Parabrahma and Brahma. Aham Brahmasmi, that does not mean Aham Parabrahmasmi. Aham Brahmasmi, I am also spirit soul, but not the supreme. Parabrahma is Krishna. I am also Ishara. Ishara means control. You are also Ishara. That's why in this school, the teacher is Ishara in his class. He is controlling some students. I am controlling my disciples. I am also Ishara. Everyone can be Ishara. There is not. Everyone can be God. But we are using the word Godhead. Just like there are some clerks and there is head clerk. Similarly, we are all gods. The Mahabharata philosophy, they say everyone is God. That's all right. But you are not the head God. If there is God, there are so many gods, there must be one head God. That is our natural experience. Anywhere you go, there are so many people, but there is some leader, head. I had some talks with one Russian professor, Professor Katov in Moscow. So we had long talks. At last I asked him, Mr. Katovsky, I forgot to comrade, but I said, Mr. So what is the difference between your philosophy and my philosophy, or our philosophy? You have to accept one leader, a head, and we also accept one head. Then where is the difference between communism and otherism? So he was stopped. He appreciated very much. The difference is that you have accepted Lenin as your head and we have accepted Krishna as our head. So there is no difference of the philosophy. You have to accept. Nitya nityanam chetana chetananam. That is the Vedic instruction. What is meaning of God? God means the head of the living entities. What is the difficulty to understand it? Nitya nityanam chetana chetananam. Nitya means eternal. We are also eternal. God is also eternal. So where is the difference? So qualitatively we are one. Because God is eternal, I am also eternal. I am now some or other in disease condition that I have to change my body. But God does not change His body. Sambhamami Atmaya. He says, Atmaya, by my own willpower, I am not forced. Just like according to my karma, I have been forced to accept this material body, certain type of body. I cannot detect as I am creating another body by my karma. So the karma by Prakite Krimanani, another place, so why the living entities are getting different types of bodies? That is not the answer. Karanam, the reason is Guna Sangha Asya Sadasa Janma Junishu. Karanam, the cause is the material nature. The material nature is divided into three modes, Satogon, Tamogon, Rajogon. So, to become within the material nature, under the control of the material nature, means to accept one of these gunas. Satogon, Rajogon, Tamogon. So, if you accept the Satogon, the Brahmical qualification, Satta, Sama, Dama, Tidikha, Arjava, Khanti, Jnanam, Vijnanam, Asikam, Brahmatanma, Sava. If you associate with the Brahminical qualification, then you get nicer body. Urdham gacchanti satta svaha. Those who are associating with the sadguna, they are also described. Sadguna means sattam samam dhamam titikha arjava khanti jnanam vijnanam astikam brahmaka. This is brahmaka. So tapasya means come to the brahmaka, not to the Shudra karma. Karanam guna sangasya. Don't associate with the Shudra qualification. Now, what is the Shudra qualification? Parichajyatmakam karjam Shudra karma sabhavajam. You are highly educated, but your desire is how to get a service. Parichajyatmakam. I am highly educated. But unless I render service to somebody else, like a dog, I am not recognized. This is called Sudrakam. Why a Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya should search after service? Therefore, in this Kali Yuga, it is said, Kalo Sudra Sambhava. Kalo, in this Kali Yuga, everyone is almost Sudras. There is lack of Brahmana. There is lack of Kshatriya and Vaishya. So, in Bhagavad Gita, we find all the solutions of the human problems. All the solutions. Chaturvarnamaya system guna karma vibhagasa. Unless you divide the whole human society into four divisions, the Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya and Shudra, you must have to divide. You cannot say classless society, that is useless society. Classless society means useless society. There must be an intelligent, high-class, ideal class of men to see here is human civilization. That is Brahman. Chaturvarnam maya system gunakarma. Unless people see the ideal man, how they will follow? Jajjad atarati sreshtha lokastat anuvartat. The Brahmana is compared with the brain of the body. Unless there is brain, what is the use of these hands and legs? If one's brain is cracked, mad man, he cannot do anything. So at the present moment, because there is scarcity of Brahminical qualified men in the whole human world, it is not meant, Brahman is not meant for simply for India or Hindu, for the whole human society. Krishna never said that the Chaturvarnam Maya system is meant for India or for Hindus or for a class. For whole human society, there must be a very ideal, intellectual man so that people will follow. Brain of the society. That is the teachings of Bhagavad Gita. You cannot say that we can do without brain. Suppose from your body, if the brain is cut off, your head is cut off, then you are finished. What the hands and legs will do if there is brain? There is no brain. So at the present moment, there is scarcity of brain in the whole humanity. Therefore, it is in the chaotic condition. There is need, as it is stated in the Bhagavad Gita, the human society, the whole human civilization must be reformed in this way, that there are intellectual class of men. Naturally, there are first class intellectual class of men, second class intellectual, third class, fourth class, like that. So, the first class intellectual men, they must be Brahmanas, in the Brahmanical qualification, and they must be Krishna conscious, then they can guide the whole society in the right way, and there will be no problem. This is Krishna consciousness only. So, here Krishna says, how to become Krishna conscious? That is for the Brahmin or the intellectual class. That is being described by Krishna. What is that? Maya sattamana. The mind should be attached upon me, Krishna. This is the beginning. Somewhere or other, you have to, our mind is attached to something else. Mind cannot be detached. We have got so many desires. Mind's business to become attached. Therefore, I accept something, I reject something. This is mind's business. So you cannot become zero. You cannot become desireless. That is not possible. Our process, just like others, they say, you become desireless. That is a foolish proposal. Who can become desireless? It is not possible. If I am desireless, then I am a dead man. A dead man has no desire. That is not possible. We have to purify the desires. That is required. Purify the desires. Sarvapadhi vinirmuktam tatparatena nirmalam. This is called purification, nirmalam. Tatparatena. Tatparatam means when God conscious, Krishna conscious, then desires become purified. So we have to come to the point of not desirelessness, but to the point of purified desire. That is point. Therefore, here it says, maya sakta mana. You cannot make your mind desireless, but you fix up your mind upon me. That is required. Maya sakta mana prata. This is the yoga system. This is called bhakti yoga. And this is called first class yoga. That is described in the Bhagavad Gita. That yoginam api sarvesam madgata antaratmana. The yogi, the first class yogi, yoginam api sarvesam. There are different kinds of yoga system. But the person who has accepted this bhakti yoga, he is thinking of me also. Just like these boys and girls, they have been taught, always thinking of Krishna. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. So if you read Bhagavad Gita and chant Hare Krishna, immediately you will learn the whole science, how to become attached with this. This is called Maya Sakta Mana. Maya Sakta Mana Prattha, Yogam Junyan. To practice yoga. This is bhakti yoga. Madasraya. Madasraya means under my direction or under my protection. Asraya. So, if you read Bhagavad Gita as it is, that is madasraya. But if you interpret Bhagavad Gita according to your rascal imagination, that is not Bhagavad Gita. Therefore, it is called madasraya. Under my protection, as I am saying, we are therefore presenting Bhagavad Gita as it is. We do not change. Why you should change? What right you have got to change? If Bhagavad Gita is a book of authority, and if I make my own interpretation, then where is the authority? Can you change the law book according to your interpretation? Then what is the meaning of that law book? That is not law book. You cannot change. Similarly, If you accept Bhagavad Gita as the book of authority, you cannot change the meaning. There, that is not allowed. What right? If you have got some opinion, if you have got some philosophy, you can write in your own book why you are killing others and yourself by interpreting Bhagavad Gita. You give your own thesis in a different way, but these people, they take advantage of the popularity of Bhagavad Gita and interpret in a different way according to their own ways. Therefore, people do not understand what is Krishna. That is the difficulty. And the purpose of Bhagavad Gita is to understand Krishna. And all the so-called scholars and politicians' commentary is to banish Krishna or to kill Krishna. The Kamsa's policy. The Kamsa was always thinking of Krishna, how to kill him. That is called demonic endeavor. So that will not help you. Therefore Krishna says, you have to develop your love and attraction for Krishna. That is what. Maya saptamana prak. Yogam jinjan madasa. This yoga practice can be performed madasaya, under my protection or my devotee's protection. You cannot take protection of another rascal who interprets Bhagavad Gita in a different way. You have to take shelter directly. Of course, Bhagavad Gita instruction is there. Everyone can take shelter of Krishna directly. Where is the difficulty? Just like here it is said. Mayasakta, you have to develop your attachment for Krishna. You can do that. How these Americans and European boys have developed their attraction for Krishna? There is a process. If you adopt this process, they are with me for the last 2, 3, or 4 years. Now you detach them from Krishna consciousness if you have got any power. You cannot do that. Even you bribe them, what you can do? Their father, mother, their countrymen can give you enough. They are all rich men's sons. But they cannot give up Krishna consciousness. Even the Christians, priests, they regret that these are our boys. And they never came to church. They never liked to understand what is the idea of God. Now these same boys, they are after, mad after God. What is this movement? They are surprised. So there is a process. If we adopt that process, then everyone can become Mayasaktamana, Krishna-asaktimana. We have to adopt the process. That process is called Yogam-yanyan Madhasra. You have to accept the yoga system under the protection of Krishna personality or his bona fide devotee, representative. Then you will be. Then what will be the result? The result will be asamsayam, without any doubt. Now people are educated in all other institutions about God, but they are all full of doubts. Full of doubts. What kind of God? What is the nature of God? Whether there is God? Whether there is no God? So many doubts. But if you accept this Krishna consciousness yoga system, then you understand Krishna asamsayam, without any doubt. And samagram, in fullness, not that partial. Partially understanding of God, that is also understanding, but it will again take time, because unless you fully understand what is God, you cannot go back to home, back to God. That is the point. There are different phases of understanding that is described in the Srimad Bhagavatam. Brahmeti, Paramatmeti, Bhagavaniti, Sabda. Vadanti tat tattva vidas tatyam. The absolute truth is there. It is one, but it is realized into different phases. As Brahma, as Paramatma, and as Bhagavan. So if you understand Brahma, that is also partial understanding. If you understand Paramatma, Brahma is understood by the philosophical speculation, Mayavad philosophy, or Jnana Marga. Then you can understand partially. Just like to understand the sunshine is partial understanding of the sun. It is not full understanding. Full understanding, if you have got power to go to the sun globe to see the predominating deity there, Vibhushan, the sun god, then it is full understanding. If you think that understanding the sun sign, you have understood the whole feature of the sun globe, that is wrong. Similarly, to understand Brahma, impersonal Brahma, is also partial understanding. And to understand Paramatma, Ishara Sarva Bhutanam Diddeshe Arjuna Tishtati, that is also little higher state, and that is also partial. But when you understand Bhagavan, the Supreme Personal, that is full understanding. Therefore, it is said, Bhagavan Ubhasa, Bhagavan Ubhasa, full understanding. Vyasadeva could have said Krishna Ubhasa, but because Krishna is understood wrong way sometimes by the fools understand. Therefore, he says directly, Bhagavan Ubhasa, Bhagavan Ubhasa. You cannot question the statement or instruction of Bhagavan. Bhagavan means opulence. There are six kinds of opulence. Bhagavan means one who is full with six kinds of opulence. So nowadays there are so many Bhagavan, but because they have no full opulences, they cannot be accepted as Bhagavan. Bhagavan means full opulence. Aishadjasya samagrasya Vidyasya, jasasya, sriya, jnana, vairagya, yastraiva, sara iti bhagavana. Full opulence, complete wealth, complete strength, complete beauty, complete knowledge, complete renunciation. One who possesses all these six things completely, he is Bhagavan. Bhagavan is not so cheap thing that it can be found in the lanes and the streets and roads. So, that is also another misunderstanding. Therefore, Vyasadeva says, see, Bhagavan Ubhasa. He is complete in everything. Ishara Parama. Ishara means controller. Parama means supreme. No more, better than that. That also enunciated by Krishna in the Bhagavad Gita. Matta Parataram Nanya. There is no more superior element than me. So, if we study Bhagavad Gita, if we understand what is the nature of Bhagavan, then our life is successful. Asamsam samagrama yathagyasya sita sisu. So Krishna is describing himself. You try to understand from the statement of Krishna with your logic, argument, science and everything, you'll find complete answer. So this Krishna consciousness movement is not a concoction of mind. It is scientific. It is based on the Vedic knowledge. It is primarily on the background of the teachings of Bhagavad Gita. If we take to this Krishna consciousness, then our human life, its mission will be successful. That is our request to you all. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna. The difficulty is that when you are admitted into some school, if you accept the regulation of the school, then you make progress. And from the very beginning, if the student says, why shall I do this? Why shall I do this? Then there is no question of making progress. If the teacher says, the right A like this, like B, like this, and if the student protests, why shall I write this? Why not this way? Why not this way? Then how you make progress? So our difficulty in this country, they have learnt everything. Although they are rascal number one. That is the difficulty. When we put Krishna, here Krishna is the sage, and Shastra says, Krishna to Bhagavan Sam. All these people will come forward, why Krishna shall be the Bhagavan? I have got another Bhagavan, I have got another Bhagavan, another Bhagavan. That is it. But these four people, they have no idea of another Bhagavan. So I am speaking to them, Krishna is the Supreme Person, they are accepting and making progress. This is difficult in this country. Krishna says, we are very much proud of reading Bhagavad Gita, but we don't accept Bhagavan as Krishna as the Supreme Bhagavan. This is our division. Krishna says, Matta Paratanam Nanyam. There is no more superior element than me. So why we shall accept Krishna? Krishna says, Sarvadhanman Paritajya Mamekam Saranam Bhaja. The so-called scholars, it is too much. Why? This is the division. They read Bhagavad Gita, but they read in their own way. And the purpose is to kill Krishna. That is it. Kamsa's philosophy. Kamsa was always thinking of Krishna, Krishna conscious. But what is the thinking? How to kill Krishna? What is that? The Rama and Krishna the same. Rama vinuttis kala niyamena tishthan Krishna sang samabhavat paramapumanaju Govinda madhi gurisantamahan. We don't distinguish between Rama and Krishna. Rama is the Supreme Lord, Krishna is also the Supreme Lord. Rama vinuttis kala niyamena, not only Rama, there are so many other forms of Krishna, they are mentioned in the Shastra. That is summarized in the Srimad Bhagavatam. That all the names of God, incarnation mentioned here, enlisted. But Krishna's too Bhagavan. The name Krishna, that he is the supreme original personality of God. Yes? No, guna karma. Just like engineer is by his qualification and by his work. Suppose a man is qualified as an engineer. So he should be accepted as an engineer. But if he does not work as an engineer, then also he will not be accepted as an engineer. If he simply passed engineering qualification and sit down at home, nobody will go to consult him. If you work as an engineer and you have got the qualification of engineer, then you are an engineer. Similarly, one must possess the qualification of Brahmana, the qualification of Kshatriya, Vaishya, and he must act accordingly. Guna karma vibhava. Chatut bandang maya sista. Akapungi dijat sreshtha vannasama vibhava sanushthitasya dharmasya sansiddhi harito sana. As the different parts of the body, the head, the hand, the belly, the legs, all of them combined together, trying to serve this whole body. Similarly, there for convenience sake, there must be Brahminical class, Kshatriya class, Vaishya class, Sudra class, and all together they should maintain the whole body. That means the whole. Whole is Krishna. Everyone should be engaged in Krishna consciousness. But it doesn't matter. For management of the society, there must be a first class intellectual class, a first-class, brave class who can defend the whole society, and there must be productive class, and there must be liberal class. This is very simple to understand. But everyone should be engaged for understanding Krishna consciousness. That is transcendental cultivation. Everything is clearly described in the Bhagavad Gita. Yes? Yes. It has got a medicinal effect. That is described by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Cheta dattana marjanam bhava mahadavagni nidvapanam sriyak kairava chandrika vitaranam vidyavadhi jivanam anandam vidivardhanam prativadam purnam mritasadhanam Param Vijayati Sri Krishna Sankirtanam. If you chant this Hare Krishna mantra, then all these things will come one after another. The first thing is Cheta Dharpana Marjanam, cleansing of the heart. All rascal things are within our heart. If you chant, if you hear the vibration, because it is transcendental vibration, Krishna, the chanting and Krishna is not different, absolute. Here in the material world, the name and substance are different. But in the spiritual world, this vibration is coming from the spiritual world. Golokera premadhana hari nama sankita. It is not manufactured within this material world. It is coming down from the spiritual world. Just like some vibration comes, some news comes from other country. Similarly, it is from another nature, superior nature. There from coming, it is down by parampara system. It is brought by Narada Muni. Thus if you chant, say, this name is not different from Krishna. Therefore, chanting of Hare Krishna mantra means associating with Krishna directly. So, if you associate with Krishna, then you become purified. You become purified. Cheta darpana mahajana. As soon as you have got clear consciousness, then bhavamadi, all the problems of this material world is finished. Brahma bhuta prasanna atma na sochati na kaam. So this is the effect of chanting. Why don't you try it? Yes. Yes, you can chant Rama. Somebody chants like that. Hare Rama, Hare Rama. That does not make any. So you take Rama card. Thank you very much. All right, chant Hare Krishna. Yes, you want to ask something? Yes. In other countries? Yes, we are therefore teaching this Krishna philosophy everywhere, so that they may take to the philosophy of Bhagavad Gita everywhere, and they are taking it. It will take some time, but this is necessary. Without taking this Krishna philosophy, you cannot descend.